Welcome, everyone. I'm Jesse Burst of Smart Grid News. I'm your host and your moderator today. And we're here to talk about a topic that's really of great relevance to every utility, and that's namely how to future-proof what we're doing. Now, we've all heard the warnings about the disruptive changes on the way, the dangers to the business model, the mandates for renewables and net metering, the possibility of electric vehicles, the onslaught of distributed generation, on and on. But, you know, what are you supposed to do about these things? Do you just sit there and wait for the tsunami to hit the shore? And fortunately, there are steps that you can take to prepare. And as you'll hear, there are ways to be more adaptable. And chief amongst them is to think multi-purpose. Think in terms of products and services that are versatile and flexible so you can adapt as the future reveals itself. And we've got a really an all-star panel with us today to coach us on that topic and to pass along their lessons learned. And I'll introduce all of our speakers in more detail when it's their turn to speak. But very quickly, we'll hear from Ron Pate from Elster, and he'll be followed by Kevin Cornish from Black & Veatch. And then we'll finish up with Douglas Marks from Pacific Corp. Now, here's some of the things you're going to walk away with today. From Ron Pate of Elster, you're going to get a great summary of what's headed our way and how to prepare. And then he's going to give you some examples of things to look for in the equipment that signals that it's adaptable and versatile. Next, from Kevin Cornish of Black & Veatch, we'll get more about the challenges of this future, but also about the opportunities it gives us. And then we're going to finish up by hearing from Douglas Marks of Pacific Corp about some of their real-world lessons learned. So let's get started, and it's my pleasure to bring up Ron Pate of Elster. He has more than two decades in our industry, and he now heads up all of Elster's solutions and product management worldwide. Now, in that two decades, Ron has worked with dozens and dozens of utilities around the world, so he brings a very broad and informed perspective. Now, I talk to smart grid experts all day, every day as part of my job. And in my research for this webinar and my reading of Ron's articles and white papers, I found him to be really one of our industry's most thoughtful and forward-thinking executives, and I'm really pleased he's able to join us today. So Ron, welcome, and thanks for joining us.
Thank you, Jesse. So I've put together some technology views of what might be to come in the future based on a pretty wide review of what's happening globally as well as in North America. And similar trends are being seen throughout the world now and in different regions, and a lot of similarities. And as I looked at that, the three of the highest things I think that came out about where we are today with regard to the electric grid is, one is in every developed region, it is absolutely vital to our way of life. There are regions around the world that are in the stages of developing, and it's going to be vital in those areas as well to improve the way of life. The current state of the grid is poised for major advance. As it is today, it will not meet all of the future needs and all of the use cases that are going to evolve. So these are some of the premises on which I'm going to base some of the discussion today. If we look at where the smart grid is headed in the future, there are a lot of signs that are giving us direction as to what the future is going to look like. It's impossible to know exactly what every detail of the future will be, but some of the things that are coming out as common themes based on many, many, many discussions I've had, both North America and other regions, is that we are headed towards more intelligent, energy-efficient communities. And those communities are going to be enabled by fairly advanced architectural solutions. And take a keynote of solutions. It's not going to be just about individual technologies for technology's sake. It's going to be about putting those solutions together that can support the needs of these intelligent, energy-efficient communities. And it's going to require solutions that are well-architected and, as Jesse has commented, multi-purpose solutions that can solve multiple purposes with common technologies and those common technologies working together seamlessly. Those architectural solutions are going to be comprised of innovative, very diverse, fully integrated to the extent possible, and probably the most important of these four characteristics is interoperable. The interoperability is a very big challenge, but it is something that must be embraced and overcome. And the characteristics will span across all manner of sensing devices. Think well beyond simple revenue metering. This will be metering in many, many different types of devices with a wide variety of communication technologies, maybe communication families of technology, but these have to be looked at from a context of interoperable and being able to serve multiple purposes with common medias. And then information systems will evolve and data-driven applications. if we look at where the change is coming, it's pretty clear that change is going to happen at all three layers of the grid. It's going to happen in generation, it's going to happen in transmission, and it's going to happen in distribution. If you look at generation, for example, we're seeing new types of generation come on board, renewables as an example. We're seeing new things start to occur, such as the emergence of technology around energy storage. And energy storage in particular could be a disruptive technology to current business models that currently exist today, which were based on the fact that energy has to be consumed almost instantly when it's received. This can change the rules going forward. If you look at transmission, there's going to be a continued focus on grid monitoring. You're going to see more and more advances in technology around conductors. You're going to see DC, if I look across the globe, DC is now beginning to grab more and more attention, and more DC transmission is being put out. Some advantages of DC, some challenges of DC. Perhaps nowhere in the industry is more change going to happen, and particularly in North America, than in the distribution area. And some of the things that are starting to happen and that are going to trend forward in the distribution area are we're going to see a more pervasive approach to metering. We're going to have metering and sensing in areas where we didn't have it before. The technology is evolving at a pace which is going to allow metering to advance at unprecedented levels in terms of the capabilities of metering devices and the use cases from which that data driven from those meters is going to be able to be used. Diverse multi-purpose communications. The communications area is a critical area that all utilities and stakeholders need to be critically aware of and need to focus some attention on making sure choosing communication networks that can support this future. Distributed intelligence. If you look at trends that have occurred in other adjacent industries, in the military and other areas, communications are critical, but to get the responsiveness and the intelligence to support this intelligent community of the future, intelligence is going to migrate into these field devices even more than it has in the past, including metering. And finally, multidimensional interoperability. Today, the interoperability model is fairly two-way. Multidimensional interoperability means devices can talk to devices. They understand one another. Various comms networks can interface with one another. Various head ends can interface with one another. And devices may not even need to talk to a head end. They can talk to one another through multiple types of devices, multiple communications. So multidimensional interoperability. The data deluge, it is arriving, and it is bigger than people may realize. If you look at the trend, historically, we've had devices that gave data. Now we're looking at much greater types of data from pervasive sensors and metering of various types. We need to be able to convert that into information. We need to drive information into intelligence. We need to be able to take that intelligence to drive decisions, and this needs to be through end-to-end solutions. And ultimately, decisions will transform into even higher levels of understanding, wisdom, where we can start to learn from experiences and evolve the solutions that we create. This convergence of data into decisions is going to be a critical item that needs to be considered, and all utility business models and decisions need to be driven with this context in mind. The other thing about the data is not only is it going to be loads of data, it's going to be coming from multiple different sources, distribution sources, metering sources, consumer sources, and how do we reconcile this to make intelligent decisions? And it's going to be coming all the time and of greater and greater granularity. And extracting the information necessary and the intelligence and the decisions is going to require state-of-the-art solutions that can streamline for the utility decision-making processes. Smart cities will evolve. Smart streetlights are just the beginning. You're going to see consumers get more engaged. Renewables are going to definitely expand. We're already starting to see that. The technology is starting to evolve such that technology prices are declining and capabilities are expanding. We're going to see changing of loads as electric vehicles come about, for example, and other loads that aren't yet perhaps accounted for. These loads will start to change and we'll start to have pervasive metering even in these loads that become mobile. If you look at homes getting greener and much more connected, and so how is that connectivity to the home going to happen? These are critical decisions that have to be accounted for as we look at where the future is going. And finally, we're going to see microgrids start to increase, and this too is going to create unique challenges when you talk about a common grid versus a microgrid. What is the interconnectivity and the business models to support that? So the smart community is going to evolve in the future. Metering and sensing is an area that many of us historically perhaps have looked at metering in very discrete buckets where maybe we have metering inside of buildings, and we had metering on the service location. We may have even treated those totally separate. We have other types of metering. What we're going to find is that metering and sensing is going to evolve across the entire grid infrastructure. And we're going to have not only metering at the electric service point, not only metering inside homes and businesses on a greater scale even, and we're going to see that start to even over time permeate into devices within the homes as smart homes evolve further, and how does that connect to the utility assets. We're going to see increased metering on the distribution grid, but not only on the grid, but in the assets themselves. Transformers is one of the areas that is going to see some of the significant increases. As transformers age, more and more distribution assets such as transformers will see metering. In mobile devices, think an automobile with a meter. On and in distribution assets, not only will transformers be retrofitted with metering, they'll come with metering built in. So we're going to have metering and sensing everywhere, pumping this data up in high granularity. Communications networks. How are communication networks going to look in the future? We're going to see advanced multidimensional interoperability. This is something that is on the forefront of technology right now. Elster and many other technology vendors are looking at this. How do we start to allow these various different types of communication networks to collaborate? And standards are not enough. It requires standards, but it also requires industry participation. It is vital that all stakeholders in industry be involved in helping drive the interconnectivity and interoperability of multi-dimensional interoperability of communication networks. And as communication networks evolve, there will be purpose-built communication networks. There will be purpose-built communication networks for one purpose that may need to interact with others. Multi-layered architectures. You'll have multi-purpose networks of different types layered on top of one another according to the specific use cases. For example, we may have super high-speed networks for distribution transmission. We may have slower networks for metering and sensing, but these have to collaborate and cooperate in tandem and in unison. Multi-purpose networks. Networks must be able to handle various types of use cases such that you can get common backhaul across these various layers of these multi-layered architectures for multiple uses. And finally, multi-network devices that include multiple communications embedded right in the devices themselves. As we see the trends in the industry, devices are getting more tightly integrated and use cases are evolving, and these things will create a fairly unique environment. Metering, for example, today you see cellular, you see mesh radio connected, and you can see other types of communication networks such as Zigbee all embedded in the same device. I mentioned before it's critical that everyone that's a stakeholder in the industry start to look through the context of end-to-end solutions. When products and technology choices are made, it is critical that we look across the entire smart grid value chain at how to extract the most value from those technology investments and those investments in smart grid infrastructure with a holistic viewpoint. And this holistic viewpoint cannot only be about technology, it also has to be a holistic viewpoint with regard to the stakeholders involved in the industry. We have consumers, we have utilities, we have regulators, we have technology suppliers, we have integrators. There are a large number of stakeholders, and we have to look across the value chain, and we have to look across the stakeholder, and we have to make holistic decisions with a long-term view in mind. So ultimately, we will have utility business model evolution. This is absolutely going to happen. It is essential. You've heard before the term in the industry of a death spiral. I personally believe it will be a transformation. It will not be necessarily death. However, it is critical that utilities find ways to evolve as these large changes are starting to happen in the industry and as the pace of technology in itself starts to increase rapidly. Not only is it technology, but it's other aspects of the industry that are changing as well, which will impact this need for a strong focus on utility business evolution. For example, utilities and other industry stakeholders are experiencing a changing workforce. We have institutional knowledge that will be leaving the building soon, and we need to find ways to help support the utilities understanding how to embrace this changing workforce and through sharing of knowledge, et cetera. We have increased stress on an aging grid. As a former transformer designer many years ago, I understand all too well what's happening in the distribution grids, and transformers are aging. They're aged design life approximately 40 years, and we're starting to approach that in many cases with large amounts of assets on the grid. Increased stress in other areas as well. Environmental and political pressures will not cease to grow, and this needs to be embraced as well. policies and regulations are being evolved, and regulators need to understand fully the technology implications and the business implications of choices, and it'll require an industry collaboration to help make sure those policies and regulations can support the future. Greater consumer awareness and engagement. We're going through generational changes with the consumer base. We're starting to gain more and more acceptance. This too will be an important impact. Energy cost escalation is going to occur. Rapid technology change, as already discussed, these will lead to a utility business model evolution that's going to require collaborative effort in order to solve these challenges across all industry stakeholders.